This is John Cola with GrownYourGreens.com today. We have another exciting episode for you coming out here from my amazing front yard garden here in California. And today we have another guest. We have Josh of the Boogie Brew Company. You may have seen the last or maybe the one before the last episode where Josh talked about Master Mark's like super intense, like super soil and growing method for growing medicinal herbs, also known as cannabis. You could also use it for growing hemp, which I would also encourage you guys to do. Or even the vegetables. And today's episode is about the 911, which Josh talked about, which I don't really know what it is. I've never done any of this stuff. And here's the thing, right? I just put out the good stuff, like all the good ingredients that like Master Mark would use in my garden, and even more than that. And I don't even worry about all this stuff. This is like extra credit. This is like if you're growing cannabis, like indoors, and you want to like inch it up and take it to the next level, you should probably pay attention to this. I'm not a soil agronomist and like into all this stuff, so this is just for you guys that are growing cannabis that you need some help to dial in your technique to get the most yield. So, Josh, what are we talking about? This 911. Like, I think 911 is an inside job. Is this an inside job?
This is the inside. The inside methodology to practice stoner-proof farming. In John Kohler's case, he's got it right. When you give it enough vitamin L, the love, who cares about the numbers? Right?
Yep.
That's what you're doing with your garden for the last...
And I know, I mean, I can't be micromanaging every little soil thing, man, like...
But when you're trying to grow the highest grade medicine on earth...
I agree.
When you're trying to get...
And that's the stuff I want to take.
Some GYG science.
Yep.
Let's get a little nerdy here, John. Let's fool around with some numbers.
You're going to do that stuff, because that ain't my thing. All right, so I want to give you guys a quick update, actually. So I ate that bud in the other video, and dude... After about 1 hour, it hit me. And like, I did not heat it. I didn't eat anything with it. And actually, I hardly ate anything that day at all. I think I had some fruit like earlier in the day. And then I got high for like 5 hours, which was definitely not a fun experience. It just knocked me out. Basically, I passed out.
You weren't even able to call.
No, I won't. Let's not say anything. But was able to call. But then anyways, I was able to call
not
somebody.
Not me, but someone more important than me.
Somebody more important than you, Josh. Sorry.
What's her name?
Can't say anything in the video, man. It's like a private situation right now, so maybe something will happen. So wish me luck, guys. And
who's this mysterious girl?
No, nope, not saying anything, Josh. We can't say anything, dude. Like, can't be on camera yet. Maybe you know. Once.
So you're telling me that from a bloody little wussy doosy dose of 5% THC raw cannabis bud that I was in the previous episode discussing Master Mark's soil recipe with you while you ate live that little wimpy dose.
Right.
Without even cooking it.
No cooking, no eating.
No decarboxylizing.
None. Maybe they've been lying to you all these years.
No avocado oil.
Nothing.
No coconut
plain,
oil.
Plain.
You just ate it raw.
Ate it raw and then...
And you're trying to tell me you got high for 5 effing hours.
Yeah, it took about an hour to take effect, and then for 5 hours I was out, then I woke up, and I still felt like hungover,
uh-huh.
Or whatever, the weed over, high over, and then it still, like, now, and it's been like 20 hours or 18 hours, like, it's pretty much wore off, so I'm like, thank God, because even in the morning, like, I felt like a little bit different than I normally do, which I don't really appreciate personally. But for those of you guys that enjoy that, hey, more power to you.
Oh, my God, I would kill for your experience. I mean, I could nibble on those buds that you pulled out of that package you bought from a legitimate dispensary. I could nibble on that all day and not feel a bloody thing.
Well, dude, I have very low tolerance because I don't get high as much as everybody thinks. John, you're high in your video. I'm never high. Well,
he's never high.
There's one, maybe two videos that accidentally this happened, of course. But
right.
Other than that, I'm high on life.
How many
guys,
videos have you done? Well over 1,000. Are you up to 2,000 videos?
No, dude, I'm like at 1,500.
1,500.
Maybe 1,600.
1,500. 1,600. He's been high in one.
Or two.
So
maybe three.
Right. Forget all your presumptions.
But I'm high on green juice,
right,
dude.
He's
like
high on
alkaline.
Life.
Alkaline diet. That's why when you smoke, you get an alkaline hit.
Right.
Like, you know, I drink green juices, like eating my Ashitaba today, man. Like, this is life.
This is a cancer
get
buster.
Get into your other greens, guys. If you guys are growing cannabis green, I want you guys to grow, like, your other greens. Like,
still tastes good.
Yeah, that's a flowering, dude. That's pretty rare. Nobody
I just took
to
a nap
like
under it.
I've never even eaten
You've never eaten the flowers, so I'll give you a report. I can tell it's
strong as hell. Let me try it.
It's definitely cancer killing.
Yeah, and there's like pollen and everything in there, man. It's all over Josh's shirt. It's like eating cannabis flower, but I'm not going to get high off this one.
That's true, Ashitaba, but it will kill cancer cells, and so did the 20% CBD, 5% CBD bud that you ate.
Well, it's 13% CBD.
Even though Her Highness, whoever she is, never received a call from you last night.
No, she did, but she wasn't there the first time. I would have talked if she answered, but she didn't answer, and then I passed out.
Right? Why do I somehow believe you?
Dude, it's totally true.
Somehow you
I don't make up shit.
You know, you can't shit a shitter. You can't shit a shitter.
I was messed up, man.
All right.
Well, all right, so anyways, on with the video, man. Right. Like, enough about that. So, dude, 911, what is this scheme? What is this program? Why should people do it?
This is the stoner-proof method of farming. I don't care what program you're on, what nutrient, a.k.a. deadrient, dosage, regime. It's such BS. When these fertilizer companies print you a spreadsheet, people love spreadsheets. How do we get so all damnified, you know? Do you think your plants give a damn about spreadsheets? Anyway, a lot of these companies are going to advertise to you, hey, buy our nutrient, aka deadrient, our chemical products. Use this tool, parts per million pen, to measure the dosage of these deadrients. Totally foreign language to a man who only measures life. Mr. JK next to me,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I have a video on that. Right. I'll post down below. How do you know your soil's good? You got a lot of worms.
You smell it. Maybe how many worms are in there. You know, how much, just, you can tell.
Like, when you're check the texture,
right,
smell,
when you get
color.
High from eating a raw bud that's only 5% THC to begin with, something tells me your body is intrinsically clean and they're connected to nature and you don't need no 9/11 stoner proof.
Yeah, how much is that thing, man? I just saved myself a bunch of money.
You know what? This tool. Okay, so you
what
can get.
What is it called, man? First, it's called the Bluelab Truncheon.
This is the Bluelab Truncheon
Nutrient Meter.
This thing is gold to all growers because this will tell you reliably when your plants are getting hungry. Now.
Normally people that use chemicals and deadrients are using this, right?
Because yeah, I mean,
that's critical, right?
The hydroponic, a.k.a. nutrient, what I call deadrient industry, they sell these things. You go and you buy your liquid bottle crap, and they sell you one of these parts per million pens, these EC meters, electrical conductivity meters. This happens to be the best one. Here, let's pull it out for your viewers. It's called the Bluelab Truncheon. This is an invaluable tool, even for those people who insist on dabbling with chemicals. This is a valuable tool if you're going to practice those means. But guess what? For those who practice life-sustaining...
Hybrid or even life-sustaining.
All right, yeah, if you want to go hybrid, if you're one of these people that want to cling desperately to the myth of buying a liquid product with a sexy label on it and thinking that that feeds your plants, at least use a tool like this to moderate the amount of this crap that you're feeding them. For all others, this will still work as an organic monitoring tool, as a device invented, or not invented, but improvised by the chemical industry to allow you to monitor your so-called hydroponic nutrient, aka deadrient reservoir levels. Instead, you're gonna use this device. Now, you can buy Amazon pricing $15,
$20. $15 for this?
Well, not this, but I mean, you can buy the cheapy, cheapy little sexy.
So what are they looking for? Just a pH, or they want
no,
an
no,
EC?
No. I mean, you can do your pH. The most reliable way to do your pH is still with the old-fashioned droplets. All right.
Color-changing droplets.
Right, the color-changing droplets are still the most reliable.
As long as you're not colorblind.
They are more reliable than any sexy pen. Now, you can buy a pH pen. They're not worth the plastic they're made out of. The color droplets are better. However, the pen every professional gardener should use is a PPM pen. EC pen, EC meter, EC meaning electrical conductivity, PPM meaning parts per million.
That PPM is parts per million and EC is electric conductivity.
Yeah, and you know what? They all function the same way. They use their own electrodes, their own little, whatever the hell this science is made out of, whatever this is, a silicon diode, I don't know. Some in the comments, tell me what these things are.
But dude, they're sensors that like measure some kind of like resistance, and then they spit out a number. Like, that's what it is.
But I love this device. I was a grower for 14 years. I went through umpteen of those cheapy and not so cheapy, all the way up to $50, $60 price level, sexy little digital pens. Which instrument was my baby for always monitoring my girls, my beautiful boogie buds that I grew? and when to feed them. This one, the Bluelab Truncheon, all right? I don't sell this. This isn't about trying to sell you yet another GYG Boogie Brew package. This is about giving you valuable information about how to proceed as a professional farmer and have your plants tell you when to feed them.
Well, I mean, if you're really into your plants, you can kind of look at them and see, right?
Hey, excuse me, another compensator just drove by. The louder the exhaust, the bigger the pipe, the smaller their you-know-what. So I apologize for the decibel interruption. Yeah, you know, if you're really connected to your garden, if you're not obsessed about feeding your prized medical girls exactly what they need when they need it and nothing when they don't, then you know what? Besides being entertained by this Josh and John interaction, this video isn't for you. For all others who want to professionally monitor their cannabis plants, their pepper plants, whatever it is they're gardening, and they want to know when to feed them and when to not, use this device and not one of the cheapy pens on Amazon. This one, I think these run about a hundy. About $100, yeah. The best.
I mean, there'd be other money I'd put in for $100 to buy something else, like some good worm castings to make some tears. I'd buy actually your compost tea before I bought that pen, but that's just me.
That's a good point. Would you spend a hundy on Boogie Brew before you spend a hundy on a Blue Lab?
I'd spend the money, $100, on actually filtration before I bought that personally, too, if you don't have filtration. I mean, it's like all in levels. Like, right. You know, there's priorities in life, you know, and like, I have priorities in like what I think is more important. Maybe some people, if you're doing chems, you better buy that first, because otherwise your plants going to be goners, man, if you're not monitoring your PPMs.
Now, I guarantee you, when we show you how to use this tool on 90% of John Cola's garden, this tool is going to be meaningless, because the numbers that we're going to talk about that you need to be looking for using this invaluable parts per million pen EC meter are not even going to barely show up in his garden. So he's got so many life forms, so many worms, so much insect frass and composted wood chip and MIT's recycled cannabis soil working for him. He's got such a super system. All of, what am I sitting on here? 4.5 feet deep, beautiful raised beds, that which should be in every driveway in America. Dump your SUVs. Replace that space with raised beds, all right? That he doesn't really need this meter to succeed. But for those of you who want to be anal, who want to get down when to scratch in a particular organic top dressing in bloom, feed them a full-strength tea, this is your baby.
So, Josh, the other thing I want to say is that this is definitely for people that have, like, pots, because pots, you can't have the whole nature in a pot. Like, I can't have it in my raised beds, because this is all my raised beds are connected with the ground, the earth, and when you're in a pot, you know, you have a limited nutrient supply in the pot. So that is definitely, I see this tool being essential, basically.
I'm also going to show you how you can use this somewhat non-essentially in what he's talking about, a whole raised bed ecosystem situation, just to kind of monitor what's going on. If you were lucky enough to have volunteers, we're looking for you, someone who really looked after your California garden, your Caliwana plantation, and they were monitoring your plant's performance, and along with it, whether they're utilizing nutrients that are already available in your wood chip rich soil, or whether they need a little dose of something, this would still be a friendly tool to use. The farmer's friendly tool right here, a parts per million pen.
All right, so Josh, let's cut to the chase, man. Right. Like, dude, how do we use this? Because normally you're measuring like liquids. How do you use this in soil?
So they sell you these things, ironically, to measure the chemicals you're supposed to feed from a very isolated system, from a hydroponic reservoir filled with detritus. Ignore all that. Why am I even showing you a parts per million pen as part of a living, Master Mark influenced, boogie living system style of growing? Why am I showing you this, John? Why am I?
You want to let people take it to the next level they want to.
You really want to take it to the next level. This is your tool, and this will also save you money, because you will not unnecessarily over-fertilize your plants, which is one of the worst things you can do to your plants, besides overwatering. Now, going back to what he said, you're going to spend your first $100 on what? Well, he got a really good filtration system. Long before we were selling Boogie Blue filters, John Cola was already of course, intuitively removing the chemicals from his organic raised bed farm in front of his house with a water filtration system. So that is the first step to a healthy garden, achieving chemical-free watering. The next step is living systems, compost teas, organic-only fertilizers, rich biological soil media.
Not just any organic fertilizer, because there's a big difference.
Well, there's a whole lot, you know, and then feeding the microbes with your rock dust. This would be useless if you poured rock dust into your soil and expected to get a reliable reading of what you've just fed them with this. Ignore all that. Ignore all the numbers on the amount of potassium and calcium and iron and all the life-giving minerals that are in a rock dust. Realize that rock dust is just going to serve as an awesome auxiliary agent for boosting microbial growth, right? The microbes don't care about the parts per million from your rock dust, all right? They're going to respond in a really positive manner to that electrical frequency input, which, as you've heard me say before, is precisely how rock dust works. And that's why compost tea will always win, because compost tea is going to activate more microbes than any rock dust recipe on earth, Herr John.
Well, we got a link down below for the video where go head-to-head rock dust versus compost tea.
The French trust the couples who squabble publicly and sort their poop out, and that's John and me, baby. We're best of frenemies for many reasons, all right? So let's cut to the chase. We're going to show you how to use this tool. Let's show them right away, starting with my favorite brand of soil.
We got the Fox Farm here.
Yeah, the Fox Farm soil. So I'm going to I took the liberty of already...
This is the Ocean Forest Fox Farm potting soil. In a pot.
Yeah. Now, if you remember the previous... This is why this is very important that this episode kind of is an epilogue to the previous one where we discussed Master Mark's recipe. We're going to go straight to the mature phase of cannabis production, the flower phase.
Wait, does Master Mark use this technique, man, to measure his stuff?
Oh my God, you know what?
Before we go on, because we're duplicating and talking about what he does.
Well, you know what? Just to throw some confusion your way before I show you my stoner-proof 9/11 way, I took the opportunity, because you told me to consult Master Mark on his feelings about using a parts per million pen on the 9/11 rule. And it's hilarious, right? We're like The View here, all right? You know the TV program, The View, where you have these women with their different political slants giving you their opinion on some certain situation that's, you know, governing our news media. But talking about growing, Master Mark has some different opinions. Let me read them to you. Let me go down here a bit. This is exciting. All right, he loves to help people, blah, blah, blah. I'm not in it for the money, just like you aren't, just like Josh isn't. Happy to share my secrets. When I was a kid, cannabis you could buy was under 10. Okay, blah, blah, blah. Blah, 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 blah. All right. Here we go, what Master Mark has to say about my parts per million. So I call it the 9/11 rule. Let's cut to the chase. The 9/11 rule means you measure the runoff with one of these devices, not what the nutrient, aka detergent companies are trying to sell you in a reservoir that you measure what you're feeding. You never measure what you're feeding before you measure the runoff. I'm going to show you that runoff thing in a minute. But the runoff, I say, if it's above 1100, then it doesn't necessitate anything being fed. Master Mark, he's pretty ballsy. He says, okay, for your information, Josh, you can run your reservoir parts at 1,200 parts per million, and he is talking organics with compost tea and top dressings, and as high as 1,500.
1,500? Isn't that pretty high, dude?
To me, that's not stoner-proof numbers anymore, John. For me, that's like, you know, I use compost tea as a first aid recipe for the lack of love, the lack of the daily commune, the lack of really caring what your plants are receiving. 1,500 is getting into race car territory. You know what they always tell you about hydroponics is like, well, it's like a race car that you're trying to keep on the track. 1,500 is a lot of horsepower. So when you have 1,500...
But that's in flower, right? Like
full
totally
flower.
Like...
All of this is based on full flower. So he says, for your information, you can run your res parts at 12 and as high as 15. And some of his buddies even run up to 18 hundi.
Wow.
Which is crazy.
And this is organic.
Yeah, style. Yeah. All organics. I mean, the brand new Ocean and Forest, we're going to measure it in a minute, should be about 18 hundi. He says he would never go that high because it would come too close to the edge. But he never tests what's coming out. This is how connected he is.
I mean, I never test what's coming out. I kind of look at what's coming out sometimes, but I never test it.
Hey, it's all vegan. What's coming out? But you let it out and you figure out what it is. He says there's too many variables that can be created. So the size of the plant, the amount of off-gassing it's doing can literally influence your parts per million. Never mind the temperature and the media itself that you're growing in. That can contribute considerably to the runoff. And if it's the immediate runoff, technically, if it's the immediate runoff, right? Let's say you just fed your plants a bunch of boogie tea and some killer top dressing like Master Mark's own chosen recipe of Nature's Pride and some tea. He says that immediate runoff is actually not an accurate runoff number because it's not a real-time expected absorption runoff. So he gave up on measuring runoff, but this is because he's so connected to his plants. For people like me who need a little more stoner-proof guidance on when my plants are hungry, I still believe in using one of these tools.
So it might be like, you know, important but not necessary if you're really dialed in.
If you're really dialed in and you're really connected, you can kind of tell. I never could, and I was a grower for 14 years. I really relied on one of these to tell me what's up. I really did.
And this could just be a good tool to, like, just check you, like, play a nice game. Like, okay, man, my PPM, based on how my plants are, how I'm sensing, my spidey senses, is at this number. And then test it and see. And then you'll get dialed in because you'll be able to compare the PPM with what you think it is, and then maybe you'll even get better.
My 9/11 numbers are stoner-proof numbers to remember. It's a sexy catchphrase. Apologies, I hope, are accepted by any direct or indirect victims of America's most recent historic disaster.
Why is it 9/11, man?
Because when the PPMs come out at 11 hundi, then you can safely feed it up to 9 hundi. And then your net parts per million in your soil that you're growing in are never higher than 2,000. But not to digress, oh shit, let me go back there. Oh my God, Master Mark just sent me some weed porn pictures. And this is what he calls the DD, the double D. This is the Daisy, his daughter's name is Daisy. He named a strain after her, and this stuff is oozing. I don't think your YouTube video camera is going to really show it.
We'll put a link down below.
Put a link to
the picture.
But this stuff is oozing, gooey, THC-rich residue straight down its stem. And by the way, he doesn't just grow a strain that was named after his daughter. He's got one after another daughter, Kyla's Cure. And then when someone tries to fake it and say that they're growing the KK, the Kyla's Cure, do you have a daughter named Kyla? Because MM himself is the man who formulated that legendary Pacific Northwest strain. And guess what? These strains, like Double D, the Daisy, it's made the cover of Oregon's Grown Weed Porn magazine. This is no joke. Just to let your viewers know, who is this mystery master? Who is this Mark character? I'm giving you some clues. He gave me permission to reveal that to your audience. Now, he also grew a mystical strain for his ex-wife. This woman is in stage 4 cancer.
Are you supposed to say that, man?
He said I could say it. I'm not supposed to reveal her name. But this woman, he created a strain named after her, and it's 35% CBD.
Oh, CBD. That's the stuff I want.
Yeah, a dream strain for John, and down to 3% THC. And
that might even still get me high.
This probably will still get him high.
No, but it's 35% CBD, so that should offset the THC,
This right? woman, his ex-wife of 21 years, thank you, Master Mark. I can't wait for you to do this interview with the Meister, all right? But just let it be told, the story, that this man cares and has created literal strains for not just his daughter, but an ex-wife who's dying of cancer, too. Health is our only wealth. Remember this, people, and this is what this man teaches you. Now let's get back to business and talk about my 9/11 rule. It's getting dark before 4:20 in the afternoon California time. I want you to know what Josh's 9/11 rule means. It's a parts per million pen. You can Google those. There are links to Amazon $15 ones that might last a few months. My favorite is the Bluelab Truncheon. It's actually the least accurate, but the most reliable. So when I say reliable, measure the runoff if you can, and if not, I'm gonna show you how there's a workabout method here with his raised beds. Measure the parts per million in your soil and what those plants that you're growing in that soil are using in that PPM, in that parts per million. And whenever you water, take an opportunity, if you can get some runoff out of a container or in a raised bed, as I'm gonna scoop the soil and show you how to do, measure the runoff. Because every time you do, ideally, those numbers will gently be dropping. What does going up mean? It means you need to flush. You have too much fertilizer. You've been OCD. You've been too nerdy. You've gone in there. You've fed too many, God forbid, chemical so-called nutrients from a hydroponic reservoir, detrients, or indeed, too rich of a soil early on in growth, or too much back guano, too much of a top dressing. So easy to overdo it with gardening. This man doesn't know the meaning of that because he only does life-giving techniques, which tend to be more focused on biology rather than direct fertilizing inputs.
All right, Josh, so let's do the runoff. So we got a pot of the ocean.
This is the ocean and forest soil.
Ocean and forest. Yep. We're gonna pour this through and then we're gonna catch it out the bottom real quick. So that's like runoff, right?
Wow, that was awesome.
It's really fast.
Now I predict this is gonna be in the upper teens and hopefully your audience can see, and that's just enough. That's all you need.
Hold
oh
it
dear.
Up,
yeah, you know what?
It's too runoff.
No, we need it stronger, I guess. This is only measuring 5 hundy. So maybe ocean and forest has come down a lot in, but I think it just poured right through there. So there's a happy medium to pouring this stuff through. If you were pouring it through a plant that had just been put into a 5 gallon bucket.
And this is like dry soil that just came out of the
came out.
It's
right.
Not
it
like
just came out.
Previously wet. We should probably pour through again
and more of it and pour it through more slowly.
And it went fast, yeah.
Yeah, because usually, and you can try this at home, usually when you pour water through a container like a 5 gallon pot with master marks like super soil or even just direct out
yeah,
of the bag
ocean, that water
it's gonna hold that water more, it's gonna take more time to get that runoff.
But this is the general principle.
This is pretty pathetic that my meter is only showing 5 hundy. It doesn't matter. Whatever it's showing, the next time you read it, if there's a drastic drop, if it comes out way lower, then guess what? It's time to feed them. A full strength tea, maybe a half strength compost tea, and a top dressing. Like the Nature's Pride that Master Mark loves, or indeed, as little as $4 a pound at your local Home Depot, the Rainbow Mix, a guano rich powder, a tea and top dressing. The next time you then read the runoff after having applied it, it's gonna come out where you want it to in the high teens. Now remember, once again, I'm talking about all mature plants. If they're babies, ocean and forest is too strong to begin with. 1800, are you out of your mind? Why would you feed your baby that many nutrients? You know, you want a milder mix. So Happy Frog, from my recollection, when I was a grower, and it's been a few years, it might have changed. Ocean and Forest used to be like 2,000 parts per million, John. But the Happy Frog was around 1,100, which is perfect for babies, and that's all they need. It's got everything they need in it. Remember, less is more, especially when you're doing high biology methods, when you're doing nothing but life. We're not what we eat, we're what we absorb in our guts. Same with your soil. So go for those lower numbers. And it doesn't have to be 9/11. It can be 12.8, it can be 15.5, it could be 14.7. The important part to remember is, once you get a drastic drop, if you monitor what you're feeding
you're looking
your
for
plants,
changes.
You're looking for those changes, exactly. Thank you, John, you just simplified it, thank you. You're looking for that big drop, and that's when it's time to feed them. A sensible, intelligent, organic, of course,
yeah, that went up
amendment.
To 600, man, wasn't it 500?
Yeah, see, Boy, it sure did. And that's
so
just,
how you read this is there's you know just a why? Little light. You
know, right, there's a light. And what I love about this meter, the Bluelab Truncheon, is how stoner proof it is, how it continues to blast that little light reading at you. So you know what, it's as it gets stronger just sitting here as I scoop it, but you guys get the drift. Okay, if we had had the luxury of pouring water through a whole bag with holes drilled in the bottom of Ocean and Forest, I guarantee you it would have come out in the mid-teens. Someone quote me if I'm wrong. Back in the day, in the 90s, Ocean and Forest was even stronger for the real gurus of growing, who knew when to use it only in flower, and they tried to make it probably more stoner proof to reach a broader audience, brought the strength down a little in the last decade or so. And typically a brand new bag of Ocean and Forest potting soil comes out at about 1,800-1,700, which is optimum for flower. Now remember, with Master Mark's recipe, he boosts that with additional worm castings. By the way, one thing we forgot to mention in the previous, here's a great way to get worm casting. Throw some worms in there. Duh. You know, you want that soil to keep living. Throw some worms in there and some hay, you know, on top for the moisture retention and just to create that unique biome. The hay, some mulch, merry mulching, get mulching.
So Josh, how would I check my like raised bed garden soil if somebody wanted to do that? I mean, I'm not gonna do that. I don't have time to do that.
Yeah, but. So the same thing, now we're gonna, and this isn't gonna read FOL, because this is your raised bed, which.
And you're getting some pretty dry soil in the
getting
top
some
there.
Dry soil.
Any more water?
Yeah. Let's pour out this. Now, if it's in a raised bed and you don't get the luxury of any runoff coming out
yeah,
of that
this
raised
is just the top, dude. This is the stuff that's already been run off and like it's probably the lowest.
But no, the topsoil is where most of the biological initial activity occurs and it doesn't matter.
So you're just
top
pouring.
Or bottom. I mean, if you have some big holes at the bottom of your raised bed walls and you have the luxury of pulling out some soil from there, fine. Whoops, I'm pouring way too much in there. So, yeah.
So we're just pouring water
in here. Yeah, just pour water in there, let it sit for a while from a raised bed. Now, take your parts per million pen, take your soil and your water that you've just mixed.
Wait, how long do you let it sit, man?
Well,
you're missing a step, dude. Like, we just let it sit like 2 seconds.
We're figuring this out as we do this video. Obviously, longer the better. So let's say you keep watering.
Well, you should actually just do it progressively, like do it 15 minutes,
exactly.
Half hour, an hour, and see if it changes at all.
I think it
more
will.
Stuff is leaching
I think
out.
It will go up. And remember, with organics, the parts per million are never that accurate to begin with. There's so much matter that is enzymatically digested.
Unconsidered.
Not yeah. Electrically conductive. So
until it's available.
Right. So that's why my numbers are lower. Like Master Mark, remember, he's primarily coming from decades of a deadrient approach, you know, of a chemical liquid approach, which he's now given up. Yeah, see, I'm not getting anything. Well, I'm getting a little higher. I'm basically getting, well, that water you gave me was purified spring water with 0 ppm. I put the ppm pen, the Bluelab Truncheon, right into his jug. Poor guy can't drink out of it anymore. But that was like store-bought 0 ppm purified spring water. Now I'm getting a reading between, on this meter, 1 and 2, which is pretty low, just as I predicted it would be, but that's all it takes for Ashitaba. For
well,
high grade.
It's also like, you know, I've cut down the water drastically, so
right.
I don't have as much like. You
and
know.
This has just been sitting here a few seconds. I guarantee if we let it sit for an hour, it'd be stronger.
I mean, we only measured what, 500 in the Ocean Forest?
It doesn't really matter what you measure.
Because you're looking for the baseline, and then you're going to like.
Exactly.
You know,
see, he's good
it's
at
it. It's not like you want it high. I want it high, man.
Right.
No, actually, you don't want it high because you want it low so you could actually feed.
Lower threshold, right? That's a good point. You want to watch those changes. Those are your indicator. Now, the Bluelab Truncheon is not very accurate, but it sure is reliable. Coated in old soil, stoner proof. You can leave these electrodes sitting here as long as the batteries, again, stoner proof, just double A's, you know, ubiquitous batteries that go in here. It doesn't matter. It's going to give you a reliable runoff measurement compared to the last time. And you ideally want to be seeing those PPMs coming down every time you water. If they're going up, you better flush, baby, flush. It's very important. You don't want your plants to die of over-nutrification. That's the worst thing. No human wants to be overfed, and no plant either. It's a very simple method, and the grow store is going to think this is crazy information because they sell you General Hydro. I'm sorry to drop industry names, but they're going to sell you part A, part B, some miracle product in a liquid form. Oh yeah, you need your PPM pen to measure the reservoir. Well, with organic growing methods and soil, there's generally no reservoir. The soil is feeding the plant. The soil is your reservoir. But you still want to use, in my humble opinion, one of these chemical monitoring devices, because it's still going to give you a reliable electrical conductivity measurement of your organic soil.
It's just a tool, you know.
It's a very good tool to use. Please follow my 9/11 method. Measure the runoff. Once the parts per million come down to 1100, then you can safely feed up to another 9. Up until that point, don't feed anything. Just love. Just compost, diluted compost teas, maybe once a week. Maybe a little foliar feast with some amino acids from the pure protein. Stuff that doesn't matter, that isn't going to affect that incredibly important osmosis relationship between proper nutrients, organic nutrients, and the plant's absorption. So
it's up to 400 now, man, because it's been sitting longer.
Isn't that weird?
300 to 400.
Don't pay no attention to these numbers. Just remember, as the PPMs drop, so it could be 15.5, it could be 13.7, 14.6, 12.8, as Master Mark says, or what Josh says, 9.11. You know, when you observe that drop.
The change.
And ideally, most of the people watching this at this point in the video are interested in their medical crop that's a hungry plant, i.e. the cannabis flower, that they're growing in organic containers, whether that's a fabric pot for air pruning or a solid pot that they've drilled holes in the bottom, but it's in the flower. This is mature plants we're talking about. This is the runoff from those mature plants. And overall, I recommend keeping that runoff in the teens once it drops to 1100 or thereabouts. Very vague, but once there's that big drop, let's say it goes from 1500 John to 1200. Okay, it's time to feed them. Now, how do you feed them? You do about 1 teaspoon per gallon of soil space. So if it's in a 5-gallon pot, this would be 5 teaspoons of your typical nutrient-dense organic top dressing powder. Like Rainbow Mix, like Nature's Pride, like the vegan mix from Down to Earth, about a teaspoon per gallon. So if it's 5 gallons, 5 teaspoons. That doesn't sound like much, but you activate it with the tea, see? And like I said in the prior video, that top dressing added as a top to an organic system, to a living system, a unique biome of biologically active super soil. And then activate it in turn with a living compost tea. And it doesn't have to be Boogie Brew. It could just be your own more simplistic worm castings and compost catalyzed with some molasses. Typical run-of-the-mill compost tea recipe. Guess what that's going to do? It's going to break the organic nutrients down in that top dressing powder. And it's going to make them so bioavailable to your soil system. Next time you measure the runoff, based on Uncle Joshy's methodology, on the Boogie Boys methods, it's gonna come out right where you want it, in the mid-teens. That's it, simple.
All right, that's basically summing it up. So Josh, I'd say that, you know, if you're just a home gardener and just growing food, this is probably not necessary. Save your money, guys. Don't be super anal about your plants. You know, they're gonna be fine. You know,
let me interrupt. You know? We get a lot of like just run-of-the-mill basil, pepper, kale. We get a lot of run-of-the-mill farmers and they still want to buy one of these top dressing powders and enrich their raised beds on occasion.
On occasion, yeah. That's good. Yeah. But I do it like once a season.
Because
I want to have good soil from the get-go, so like I don't have to feed.
It's just a continual system for you. But you know what? if you're making that investment in your plants to feed a top dressing, you might want to consult the parts per million pen before you feed it. Why would you feed that top dressing to an otherwise low-grade raised bed veggie garden soil mix if the PPMs are going up, John? Still a good idea.
Even for the
non-anal.
But also, you know, it's like too many things to deal with. Like, I also want to make it simple for people, and you don't really need this. It's not totally necessary.
That's true, but if you want to...
But if you want to take it to the next level...
If you want to go to Master Mark levels, if you want real...
And this is, of course, medicinal cannabis, where right. they're really cranking it up.
But you can extrapolate so right. much data
Absolutely.
From cannabis farmers.
Absolutely.
And you can incorporate their methodologies, no matter how mildly, into your veggie garden. And if you utilize 10% of the grow knowledge that's out there in the cyberverse of, you know, organic gardening, bio delivery methodologies for cannabis farmers, guess what? Your veggie garden, your veggie patch will rock like never before.
And grow your own medicine.
You should, yep, your medicine and your food, whether it's your strawberries from a low-grade soil, your peppers from a medium soil, your cannabis from a super-rich soil, the 9/11 rule still applies. It's still a good idea to keep one of these on hand just to monitor what is going on with your soil.
All right, I can't object to that, man.
And from now on, I'll bring this over, you know, occasionally. Like, he's here every couple of months tending to his Caliwana garden. And you know what? We'll bring this and we'll just see what's going on, one bed at a time. So the Ashitava behind us to the peppers behind them and so on. At least this will give us a clue on whether those plants are nutrient-starved or not.
I can't disagree with that, man. I think tools are amazing. You know, I have many different tools myself, or, you know, like thermometer. That's just a tool to know how hot we are if we can't know that we have a fever.
That's a good point.
You know, and it's like, just like, yeah.
But when you're as healthy as him, you never get a bloody fever.
Or very rare. So
right.
Anyway, Joss, we got to close this out. Any final comments real quick before we sign off? I think we're running out of battery time.
You know, my final comments before we waste the battery, I want to thank you all for giving me the audience I love. There's three reasons my business is still small. BBC, bicycling, I'm a selfish athlete. BSing, I love to hear myself talk. And cannabis, so at least I'm honest. And I wanna thank you for being that audience and for participating in this unique, cyclical, recycled knowledge, information, social hyphae web that we have all woven together, John, and not least thanks to you, buddy.
Yeah, no
you know,
worries, man.
This man right here. So I'm glad to inject a little 9/11 propaganda, little, you know, 707 grow code sensibility into yet another amazing episode in the endless gift to humanity that this GYG character has woven for us all free. Completely free. You could spend tens of thousands of dollars and go to ag school, or you can watch 10% of what this man has produced for you for years now. Your choice. Where do you think you're going to learn more?
Well, thank you, Josh. I mean, I try to go out on my way to learn this for myself, and then also, more importantly, share with you guys, because nobody's doing what I do. I wish there was a channel that was like mine.
There's nothing like
There's nothing you're like doing. Mine, because no. I travel so much. I have so many different angles. You know, I like to cover cannabis. I like to cover homegrown vegetables. I do a lot in my gardens, but I visit a lot of experts.
Wide spectrum.
And I mean, that's important, visiting the experts. And hopefully, Master Mark.
Hey, man,
hopefully you're
waiting.
Coming up
yep,
soon, man. And I know you viewers out there want this too, because it's going to be amazing what I'm going to see. And I'm probably going to get to try some really good stuff there.
Isn't it ironic? They're all M. So you had MIT in 2015. Then you have Mary Jane, who I introed you to in 2017. And now you've got the MM, Pacific Northwest. So keep up the M's, you know, along with the GYG. It's all, you know, it's such a beautiful web of life. It's social hyphae. You've helped us weave together, all right? I couldn't be who I am.
And neither, without you guys.
Like I said in the last hour, I'm unemployable. If you can't see that from watching me, which one of you would want to employ me? But it's precisely that's allowed me to remain self-employable, my relationship to you, the social hyphae, the miraculous web of life that we all weave together. And a lot of the knowledge that I spout forth sounding like the mad scientist that the boogie boy is. Remember, if you want to be a better farmer, remind me when to shut it.
All right, shut it, Josh. All right. Seriously, I got to go. I got to like harvest a bunch of stuff and get some stuff done before it gets too dark. But if you guys enjoyed this episode, hey, please be sure to give this video a thumbs up. Also, be sure to share this video with other people you may be able to think it could help out. Also, be sure to click that subscribe button right down below so you don't miss out on my new upcoming episodes that come out every 3 to 4 or every 5 to 7 days. You never know where I'll show up or what you'll be learning on my YouTube channel. And make sure you click the little bell so you get notified as my new videos come out. And finally, be sure to check my past episodes. I'll put a couple episode links to the ones we talked about in this episode that I did with Josh down below so you guys could check those out. Wealth of knowledge, all for free, 24/7, as long as YouTube's still running and you have an internet connection, all right? So with that, my name is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time, and until then, remember, keep on growing.